This is Harp Reel 1. Especially these indoor scenes where they've been lighted with one of those big light bars or some other high-powered light source, I will always try to expose for the faces, because otherwise we trying to bring up the dark stuff, you can lose the faces, and we don't want to do that. So you will see always typically brighter in the center with the light falling off pretty rapidly as it goes out to the edges. And there's several reasons for that, and I can give you some more information on that if you wish. Here we have the outdoor scene, and of course, it's the lighting edge to edge is much more uniform. Lenses always have more light gathering capability in the center. And that also contributes to the fall off of brightness. The edges. The other thing that's I forgot what the other thing was. I'll remember it well. Okay, so throughout these tapes, I will shut up soon, but you'll hear me making voice annotations, and you can spot these on the soundtrack. And there'll be clues about where splices are, which can help you rearrange things that might be out of order. That's a great sledding hill. lice. Okay, now for example on these, I've got the camera cranked down pretty far on exposure, and we're getting a little bit of a blowout, which is probably, you know, the way the original film is. This little bit of junk down in the lower right hand edge, that is almost assuredly recorded in the film. And it will probably disappear at the next splice. Stuff would get stuck in the shutter, and unfortunately there's no way to know it until you got it developed. But because of the way it moves, all right, I'm going to stop and look at this overlap.